Buckle up, because we're about to uncover the story of a World War II aircraft that once ruled the skies with mind-boggling speed and altitude prowess. It's not a household name like the Spitfire or Mustang, but the Nakajima Ki-87 is a hidden treasure in aviation history. This forgotten warbird pushed the limits of what was possible in the air, and its tale is nothing short of remarkable. Get ready to be amazed by the underdog that soared higher and faster than you'd ever imagine. The Nakajima Ki-87? Japan has a rich history of aircraft development, beginning from the early days of aviation to the modern era. But not many know about this incredible aircraft, the Nakajima Ki-87, a hidden gem in the skies. During the beginning of the World War, Japan was someone to be feared. It was mainly due to their superiority in planning, but it all came crashing when America introduced the B-29 in 1944 in Japanese land. It forced Japan to strengthen its on-air compact. They wanted an aircraft that was more capable of taking down the American aircraft, and one that was far superior in altitude. Nakajima was the first to work towards this idea. This led to the creation of Ki-87. The concept for these aircraft was conceived long before the B-29 was introduced. Nakajima and the Imperial Army Headquarters Technical Division had been experimenting with equipping a sizable radial engine with an exhaust-driven turbo supercharger. The Tachikawa Ki-94 was developed as a result. However, it was a failure. Ki-87 was supposed to be Plan B. The construction of Nakajima Ki-87 started in 1943. The final product was delayed due to the disagreement between the Imperial Japanese Army and the engineers regarding the position of the turbo supercharger. Finally, the engineer's idea prevailed. The maiden flight of the machine took place in April 1945.
Ultimately, the aircraft had to reach approximately 700 kilometers per hour while being armed with four cannons, two 20mm and two 30mm, so that a pilot would be able to engage enemy aircraft flying at high altitude. Mostly, the American B-29 Superfortress Ki-87 was soaring above the clouds.
Although it would take 14 minutes to climb to that altitude, the initial tests were considered generally successful, apart from the undercarriage issues, and full production for 500 of the aircraft was planned. Ki-87 was designed to counter the threat of enemy bombers and to locate enemy planes by intercepting them at high altitudes. The Ki-87 got the ability to fly at such high altitudes because at the heart of the Ki-87's ability was its Nakajima Ha-44 engine. This late-war Japanese 18-cylinder engine would give 2,400 horsepower at sea level for takeoff power, which was a significant amount of power for an aircraft of its time. This robust engine was necessary for reaching extreme altitudes and high speeds. It could climb to heights of over 40,000 feet, significantly surpassing the operational altitudes of many contemporary enemy aircraft. The Ki-87's advanced design and systems made it a complex aircraft. While this complexity contributed to its performance, it also made maintenance and repairs more challenging in the field. The engine was certainly powerful, but had some issues. It had maintenance heavy, and ultimately only around 10 were built. The four-bladed constant speed propeller was also very massive, demanding rather huge gear legs for ground clearance. Regardless, the Ki-87 prototype was finally finished and fully constructed by February 1945. The Japanese had needed these 500 Ki-87s, piloted by experienced crews, a year earlier. The single prototype was simply too little too late. Over the course of the next few weeks, the Ki-87 underwent a further 4 test flights, none of them long, and all of them with the unreliable undercarriage extended. Despite its impressive performance, the Ki-87's advanced design and complex systems made maintenance and repairs a considerable challenge in the field. Furthermore, the engine was maintenance intensive. These factors contributed to the production of only about 10 Ki-87 aircraft. The Ki-87 came too late to significantly impact the outcome of the war. By the time it was ready for testing and production, the tide had already shifted in favor of the Allies. The aircraft underwent several test flights, but its unreliable undercarriage and limited production numbers hindered its effectiveness. In the end, the Nakajima Ki-87 remains a hidden gem in aviation history, a testament to the ambition and innovation of Japanese aircraft designers during World War II. Its limited production and late entry into the war, however, meant it couldn't fulfill its intended role. What other lesser-known or hidden gems in aviation history do you find particularly fascinating, and why?